Hey, brothers and sisters, it's Brother Patrick making a second video tonight. Something that the Lord really put in my mind tonight. The problem with this, and I just made a video about a dream that I made. I'll probably load this one the next day. So if you see this video, the video I loaded yesterday is about the dream that I had. About the sudden destruction flood coming of muddy water. And one thing that represents, brothers and sisters, is false doctrine. Okay, and then the Lord began to speak to me this afternoon while I was running, and because that's what I do. I run 3 days a week, and then that's the time I use that time to really meditate on what the Lord's been trying to show me and talk to the Lord. Seems to be work for me with my relationship with the Lord. And the Lord just told me it was kind of like the movie. It's kind of like Frankenstein's monster, brothers and sisters. Kind of like Frankenstein's monster. In those movies, like Frankenstein's Monster, King Kong, Twilight. There's several other ones that you can think of. Beauty and the Beast. They always make the beast look sympathetic. The devil is doing that to make the beast look sympathetic, that the beautiful earthly woman and the beast from above, just like the square and compass of masonry, that's really what that represents. With a G in the middle, you can become a god, as above, so below. The Washington Monument, the obelisk there in front of the Vatican, the dome of the Capitol building, the dome of the Vatican, the pregnant belly of the human woman with the seed of the fallen angel trying to make man in his own image, trying to imitate God, which will produce the Antichrist. Brothers and sisters, those beasts, the beast of the Antichrist is like Frankenstein's monster and Beauty and the Beast and all that stuff. The beast is also like the false doctrine. When you take Christianity and Islam and make Chrislam, you know, even like what that saddleback, brokeback saddleback guy is trying to do, Rick Warren. And then when you got the Pope trying to do the same thing, mixing all this, you know, they're willing to throw out even what they claim. You know, the Bible says, and I believe it's 1 Corinthians chapter 15, that without the, if you don't have the resurrection, if you don't have the crucifixion and resurrection of Christ, then you don't have, if Christ didn't rise from the dead, our faith be in vain, Paul said. So, if you are ready to throw out the cross and throw out your core doctrines, then you didn't believe it anyway. You never was a believer. And just for the, in the name of world peace and unity and humanism, human brotherly love, that man's unity is the ultimate thing. That reminds me of the next video I'm going to make. You have embraced Frankenstein as a lovable creature instead of the beast and freak that he is. It's so ingrained. That idea is so ingrained in our culture because of movies like Beauty and the Beast and Frankenstein, and now the modern day stuff with Twilight and all, it's the same thing. Love and the Vampires, the Vampire Diaries, True Blood, all of these things is leading people to say, hey, women should lie with vampires, the undead, with freaks, with fallen angels, with demons, with beasts. That they are cool, they're our friends. Anyone that wants to kill Frankenstein is an evil, ignorant moron from the mountains. That's an inbred, you know, ignorant, you know, what they say about, what these sophisticated people say about Christians. We're ignorant. But something else the Lord told me, something about those people that come to kill Frankenstein. You know, they're carrying those torches of light. They're bringing the light. And Frankenstein is trying to hide in the darkness. Brothers and sisters, those movies have reversed truth, reversed reality, and presented people in our own psyche that we have this sympathy for the beast and a disgust and a hate that those who want to kill the beast are evil and the beast is good. Think about it in those simple terms, that we should love a monster and kill anyone that wants to hurt this monster, because the monster comes not but to kill, steal, and destroy. But Jesus has come that we may have life and life to the full. I'm going to cut this off because the third video idea is in my mind and I got to get it out before I get confused. I always end up making a long, long video, and you know, by the grace of God, I'm going to keep breaking it down so more people can see what the Lord wants me to put out.